cultural practices for effective pest control, creating an unfavorable environment for pests. In the world of modern agriculture, pest management plays a crucial role in ensuring successful crop yields. However, traditional methods of pest control often involve the use of chemical pesticides that can harm the environment and even human health. This video aims to provide farmers with alternative, environmentally friendly strategies to combat crop pests while preserving the delicate balance of the ecosystem. 1. Integrated Pest Management, IPM. Integrated pest management is a holistic approach that combines various techniques to control pests effectively. It involves monitoring pest populations, using natural predators, crop rotation, and maintaining plant diversity. This method reduces the reliance on chemical pesticides and minimizes their negative impact on the environment. 2. Biological control. Encouraging the presence of natural predators and parasites of pests can significantly reduce their populations. Introducing ladybugs to combat aphids or releasing parasitic wasps to control caterpillar populations are examples of biological control methods that are both effective and environmentally safe. 3. Beneficial plants. Planting certain crops or flowers that attract beneficial insects can help create a balanced ecosystem in the farm. For instance, marigolds can repel harmful nematodes, while sunflowers attract bees for pollination. 4. Crop rotation, enhancing soil health and pest control. Crop rotation is an essential agricultural practice that involves changing the types of crops planted in specific fields each growing season. This technique offers multiple benefits, including improved soil health, reduced pest pressure, and increased crop yields. Here's a more detailed look at how crop rotation works and its positive impact on pest control. Understanding crop rotation. Crop rotation involves alternating the types of crops grown in a particular area over time. Different crops have varying nutrient needs and susceptibilities to pests and diseases. By changing the crops planted in a field, farmers can disrupt the life cycles of pests and diseases that are specific to certain crops. This practice also helps to prevent the depletion of soil nutrients and reduces the buildup of pest populations. Pest disruption. Certain pests and diseases are host-specific, meaning they target particular crops. By planting different crops in a rotation, the pests that depend on a specific crop are left without their preferred host. This interruption can significantly reduce the pest pressure on subsequent crops. For example, a pest that primarily attacks tomatoes may struggle to survive in a field where corn or beans are planted the following season. Nutrient management. Different crops require different nutrients from the soil. Some crops may deplete specific nutrients, while others replenish them. By rotating crops, farmers can balance nutrient utilization in the soil. Legumes, such as peas or beans, have the ability to fix nitrogen from the air and improve soil fertility. Planting legumes in rotation can enhance the nutrient content of the soil, benefiting subsequent crops that require more nitrogen. Break in disease cycles. Certain diseases can persist in the soil and affect the same crop if it's continuously planted in the same location. Rotating to non-host crops breaks the disease cycle and reduces the risk of infection. This practice is especially effective against soil-borne pathogens that can survive in the soil for multiple growing seasons. Planning a crop rotation. Effective crop rotation requires careful planning. Farmers need to consider the susceptibility of different crops to pests and diseases, as well as their nutrient requirements. A well-designed rotation might involve alternating between different plant families, example, nightshades, legumes, brassicas, incorporating cover crops, and factoring in cash crops and market demands. Conclusion. Crop rotation is a powerful tool for sustainable pest management and overall agricultural health. By diversifying the types of crops grown in a field over time, farmers can reduce pest and disease pressure, improve soil fertility, and promote a balanced ecosystem. This approach minimizes the need for chemical interventions and contributes to a more resilient and environmentally friendly farming system. 5. Organic sprays and solutions. Farmers can prepare organic sprays using ingredients like neem oil, garlic, or chili pepper. These sprays can deter pests without harming the environment or contaminating the produce. 6. Trap crops. Planting trap crops that are particularly attractive to pests can divert them away from main crops. This sacrificial approach keeps the primary crops safe from infestations. 7. Cultural practices for effective pest control, creating an unfavorable environment for pests. Cultural practices are fundamental techniques that farmers can employ to create an environment that is less hospitable to pests. By implementing these practices, farmers can proactively discourage pests from infesting their crops. Let's delve into the details of how cultural practices contribute to effective pest control. Spacing and plant arrangement. Proper spacing between plants is crucial for reducing pest and disease spread. When plants are too close together, they can create a humid microclimate that favors the growth of pathogens. Adequate spacing allows for better air circulation and sunlight penetration, which can deter the development of diseases. Additionally, pests may find it harder to move between widely spaced plants, reducing the chances of infestation. Timely irrigation. Overwatering can lead to excess moisture in the soil, promoting the growth of fungi and other pests. On the other hand, insufficient watering can stress plants, making them more susceptible to pest attacks. Implementing a consistent and well-timed irrigation schedule ensures that plants receive the appropriate amount of water without creating conditions that pests thrive in. Weed management. Weeds can serve as hosts for pests and diseases, providing them with a breeding ground and a means of spreading. Effective weed management through practices like mulching, hoeing, or hand weeding can eliminate potential habitats for pests. Mulching not only suppresses weeds, but also helps regulate soil temperature and moisture, creating an unfavorable environment for pests. Sanitation and plant debris removal. Leftover plant debris from previous crops can harbor pests and diseases. Removing and properly disposing of plant residues after harvest reduces the likelihood of pests overwintering in the field. Sanitizing equipment and tools can also prevent the spread of pathogens from one area to another. Crop diversity and polyculture. Planting a variety of crops in close proximity, known as polyculture, can confuse and deter pests. This approach disrupts the pest's ability to locate their preferred host and reduces the risk of large-scale infestations. Diversity also attracts beneficial insects, which can help keep pest populations in check. Use of reflective mulch and barrier crops. Reflective mulches, such as silver-colored plastic, can disorient and repel pests that rely on visual cues for finding host plants. Barrier crops, like aromatic herbs or repellent flowers, can be strategically placed to deter pests from entering the main crop area. Conclusion. Cultural practices are an integral part of integrated pest management, contributing to sustainable and eco-friendly pest control. By adopting these practices, farmers can create an environment that discourages pests and diseases, ultimately reducing the need for chemical interventions. Implementing these practices requires careful planning and attention, but the long-term benefits include healthier crops, improved soil conditions, and a more resilient agricultural ecosystem. 8. Education and collaboration. Farmers can benefit from sharing experiences and knowledge about effective pest control methods. Local agricultural extension services and community workshops can provide valuable insights and encourage collaboration among farmers. Conclusion. The methods discussed in this video highlight the importance of finding a balance between successful crop production and environmental stewardship. By adopting these environmentally friendly pest control strategies, farmers can ensure a healthier ecosystem, sustainable agriculture, and a safer food supply for generations to come. Remember, combating pests doesn't have to mean compromising the environment. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment,